Jennifer wrestled her friend playfully to the ground in front of the snow cone stand and began licking at the girl's eyeballs, as if they were sugar cubes. Their bodies convulsed and flailed with an almost seizure-like intensity, at times their pale limbs seeming to shift back and forth from one torso to the other. A crowd gathered almost immediately to watch these two girls tie and untie their bodies like a pair of pit vipers. They were confused or concerned or shocked or aroused or all of the above, but no one dared interfere with the performance. Jennifer's long, ashen hair hung down, concealing the girl's face like a curtain around a hospital bed. No one had any idea that the girl's eyes were eroding under her ruby tongue. "This is disgusting. It's pornography," explained a pasty slug-like woman in a fur coat, vanilla ice cream smeared across her double chin like a money shot. Countered a balding professor type in his mid-40s, his left hand stuffed crassly down the front of his pants. "No. No. No. This is beautiful. This is art."
Yeah! Yeah. Yeah. Ah!
Everyone quickly hushed up and took a step back as Jennifer rose and stood over the girl, examining her handiwork. Her partner lay motionless beneath her, seemingly dead. Her eye sockets dry and empty. Her heels and elbows scraped and bloodied. Some onlookers gasped in horror, some swooned and fainted melodramatically, most just stared in disbelief. Jennifer reached down between her thighs and pulled the crotch of her bathing suit to the side, exposing her vagina. The other girl slowly sat up and began sliding her fingers into Jennifer. A few minutes later her wrists were in, then her elbows. Eventually she would completely disappear into her womb. Jennifer tilted her head to the side curiously. She heard the sound of a rickety wooden roller coaster in the distance, its passengers screaming in mock terror. She knew that sooner or later they would realize that the ride wasn't stopping and they were all going to die.
Thank you.